Hi everybody, let's go ahead and start our today's experiment. And today's experiment is about ballistic pendulum. And in this particular lab experiment, we are going to combine the law of like conservation of energy and momentum. So we'll use conservation of energy. We'll also use conservation of momentum. To find the initial speed of an object, some textbooks, use it as they use the term bullet, but in our lab it's not really like a practical kind of bullet. It's just a small ball that we will use, and then we will use it like to embed it in inside a bigger mass, and then we will use conservation of energy and conservation of momentum concepts to find its initial speed. So this is the way it works. For instance, the ballistic pendulum setup looks like somehow like this. So let's say like you have a mass that is suspended like this. We literally have this lab setup in our lab. So there is a mass, some kind of block of mass, which is made of metal, and as much as possible we try to minimize friction over here, so that we'll try to get as close as we can to find the initial speed of so then there is a ball, and the ball, we have some kind of a spring gun just attached to the ball. Probably I will use a different color for this part. So then what we do is like we compress the ball or the spring, and all of a sudden like we shoot, the strength of the stiffness of the spring is considerably high, so that like we should be able to shoot that ball and then embed it inside this box. Okay, so now the process is like this thing has its mass and it has an initial velocity. Okay, and this, the bigger mass, has a mass, let's put it as uppercase, and it has an initial velocity of zero because it's not moving, it's just simply hanging. Now what happens is like when we shoot the small mass, and then what will happen is like the whole system is going to move, right, somehow to a certain level, right? So the first thing is going to happen is the following before it just moves the whole way into to this location, right? So it moves like whole way from where it started, and then it moved a height of h, right? So let's consider this h initial, or its first position is zero, and its h2 is, let's say, is going to be h, right? So in general, like the whole mass, the whole system, the box and the ball, they will move a height of h, right? So now before, as soon as this thing, this little mass will shot, what happens is like both masses, like for instance, and then this little mass is going to come and embed in there, and both of them will have a common velocity v initial. Let's use uppercase. So v is common velocity, or common speed, All right, right after collision. Okay, collision. Now, what is happening is now there are several items happened here. First, the conservation of momentum happens. So from momentum, what we know is you had an initial momentum of the little mass, right? Just before they collided, right? The initial momentum of the green box is zero because it was just hanging. And then there is a final momentum. Then that final momentum is achieved by both of them, m plus uppercase m, and they have a common velocity v right after collision, right? So this is before, this is after. See, now our overall goal is to find the initial velocity of the ball. Then from here you can see that the initial velocity of the ball is going to be m plus uppercase m divided by m multiplied by uppercase v. Uppercase v is the common velocity. Now our idea is like, now what are the knowns? We know the mass, we know uppercase mass, you know this, but the thing is we don't know the common velocity, the common initial velocity, but we can find it. We can find that common initial velocity if we apply the energy equation. So right after collision, the two masses, this green box and this ball, they have an initial velocity. Because of that initial velocity, they have a kinetic energy. Okay, and then those both masses will swing to a maximum height. That means they are going to convert the total kinetic energy that have here at location one, and then that will be totally converted to a potential energy too, because the thing is going to swing by a certain angle to a maximum and achieves a maximum height. That means it's going to come down right after that maximum height, right? So therefore there won't be any kind of kinetic energy at location two. The only kind of energy that you are going to have is potential energy at two. So that means this total kinetic energy at point one is conserved or converted to a potential energy at two. Okay, that's the conservation of mechanical energy. We talked about this in the theory video of the conservation of energy. So now we proceed to energy conservation, right? So right after the collision, what we have is a kinetic energy. Okay. And of course the potential energy is supposedly zero because there's no height for the two masses. At H1 is zero, right? You can see here. So that kinetic energy is completely converted to potential energy. There's no kinetic energy at location two. You know, conservation of mechanical energy states that the total energy that's potential and kinetic at initial is equal to potential and kinetic at the final. But the thing is we really don't have any potential energy at location one and no kinetic energy at position two. So now kinetic energy at position one is half times the two masses together and of course uppercase velocity square, and potential energy at location two is the two masses, gravity, and then whatever height that mass is going to move at. So you have you have a common term on the left and on the right, then that will be eliminated, right? So therefore, from here, what you will have is like v squared, you know, you can take 2 to the other side, is equivalent to gh. So from there, then v will be the square root of 2gh, right? So if you take this v equation that you get, you can call this equation 2 and this one as equation 1. And if you substitute equation 2 in equation 1, then you can find, because you can measure h, right? So therefore, your v naught or v initial of the small ball can easily be calculated as m plus uppercase m lowercase m multiplied by 2gh. So this is by combining 1 and 2. Okay, this equation was obtained by combining those two equations. Okay, all right. So therefore, you just simply apply this formula and then you are going to find it. But as always, what's going to happen is we're going to use a simulation and then we'll try to apply or use that simulator and try to solve the problem. Okay. But the thing is, our simulator, this guy, it doesn't give us h. Rather, it gives us, as you can see here, what is the height of, or I mean the length of the string. See this string? It gives you that, okay? But the thing is, you know what? It's just fine. You can find h using that length. So how do you find it? So I'm going to show you, because we are going to use this this simulator for our experiment. So let's go ahead and then I'm going to show you how to find it. All right, so now we already have the equation m plus uppercase m divided by lowercase m multiplied by the square root of 2gh. That is going to give you what v is. But the thing is, how are we going to find h? So the process is like we need to find h. So yes, you can measure h. Then if you measure h, then you're going to literally find the solution or v calculation. But the thing is, we're going to be using a simulator. Okay, a simulator. Then this time, the simulator that we will be using is something like this, as you can see here. But here, for instance, if I, just as an example, if I shoot this, then, you know, it doesn't give you like h directly. What it does is like it gives you a maximum angle, the angle that this whole system swings. Okay, so but if I get that angle, I can find h. So how? I'm going to show you how you can do that. Okay, so originally, if you remember, you know, our mass is hanging like this. Okay, then the simulator gives you the length of this guy, the length of the string. Then after the small mass embedded in it, what would happen is like this system is going to move up here, right? Small mass is embedded in there. What we're trying to find now is h, how much height it went up, right? So that means we are looking for this h, okay? But that h is literally the same as this h, from here to here, okay? But if you see it like your angle theta is given, this is what theta is, and this is what L is. Okay, so if you can find this length, let's call it y, then we know that y plus h is the same as l, but y is adjacent to the angle, and L is the hypotenuse of a right triangle. Right? So therefore, Y equals L cosine of angle theta. Right? So that means this H will be the overall L minus Y. So therefore, your H can be found as L minus Y, where L is L and Y is L cos of theta. So if you can go ahead and then like take L as your common factor, it will be 1 minus cosine of theta, right? So you can find H like that, and then you take this H and substitute it in here. Then you can find the initial velocity of the ball, or the mass, or sometimes the bullet. Okay, so now let's go ahead and then do one simulation. What I'm going to do is like I'm going to fully solve that, and then you do like three trials for the experiment. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and pick my given parameters. What the manual is going, I mean the simulator is going to give me, then I'm going to take that and it's just like God and then substitute it. Okay, so every time you can end it, you can verify your answers, like, you know, you just type your, like, you know, your name, let's say, and then whatever you calculated using our equation, like let's say 3, I'm just putting it, but make sure that it's in meter per second, and you click submit, and it's going to tell you like, oh no, the actual speed is this, the student predicted this, then, you know, and so on and so forth. But anyway, if you got the answer wrong, what you can always do is you can refresh and do a new simulation. Okay, so I'm going to write the given parameters. So everything that you have to use is like everything that is given by the simulator. For instance, gravity we know is, you know, 9.8 meters per second squared. That's the actual and the accepted value. But for the sake of the lab, because this lab normally generates new numbers for every experiment that you do, which is a good thing. So if you do this 3 times and then if you get your answers 3 times, it means like you pretty much understood everything. So use the G that is given by the simulator. Okay, you know, you can imagine this experiment is done where the value of G is like smaller than what we have on Earth. Okay, so I'm listing my given parameters. 0. We need to be consistent with units. So you either use everything in kilogram or in gram. 693 gram, and then the length of the string is 138 centimeter, same as 1.38 meter. Now what I need is the angle. So to find the angle, what will you do is like you go out and then click on the bullet, and then, you know, the simulation is going to give you a value. So the maximum angle that it gave me is 66.3 degrees. So let's go ahead and then, like, you know, try to use this and then find the value of V. Okay, so now the first thing that we need to find is, remember I used a red color to find H. So H was into L into 1 minus cosine of theta, right? So I'll be using meter because the simulator verifies my answer in meters per second. So therefore, 1.38 into 1 minus cosine of 66.3 degrees. So my H value is going to be equal to, I'll be using my calculator because I cannot do this. I have to do it like live because every time I do the simulator, it gives me a new set of numbers. So let's work on this together. So what I get is like my H value is 0.825 meter. Okay, then I'm going to go ahead and then substitute everything to find V naught. So what we know for the initial velocity, here's my equation. Okay, this one, m plus m divided by, okay, so m 54.1 plus 693, both are in grams. Why? Because it will eliminate at some point if you use all of them in grams, and then divided by the lowercase m, that means by the smaller mass, that is 54.1. Then multiply this by 2 times, square root of 2 times, gravity. Gravity, again, don't use 9.8, use whatever the simulator is giving you. Okay, and then my h is 0.825. Okay, then what would be my V naught? I'm going to use my calculator and then I'm going to substitute everything here. Okay, so then bear with me for a moment because we need to verify this together. Then you will do the rest by yourself. I'm sure that like it's gonna be easier for you to. Then the square root of 2 times 8.7 times 0.825. Okay. Then the value of V that I got is 52.32 meters per second. Okay, so yeah, this is in meter per second. That's what I got. Then let's go ahead and then verify the value that I get. How do I do that? You know, I'm going to say int and then my name, but just simply doesn't save it or it doesn't do anything. It just tells you what the answer is. 52.32, that's what we got. And let's see what. Wow, the actual speed is this. The student predicted this, so our prediction is perfect. Your answers were good. Take a screenshot of this page and share it with your teacher. So please do so, then so that, like, you know, do 3 trials like that, and that's the end of it. Okay, thank you very much. So until the next simulation, take care.